welcome back to Festive Forever. Guess what? Today we are in Borivali. So, frankly speaking, I have heard a lot about this place called Fusion Kitchen. More than anything, people come over here to enjoy and relish their innovative and mouth-watering food. I have already seen their bunch of pictures and I'm already drooling over it. So, let's go inside and check out their beautiful menu. Begin our vlog with some delicious chicken tikka nachos. These nachos are made from spinach. It's loaded with lots of cheese sauce, shredded chicken tikka, then bell pepper, olive oil. All these things you can clearly see in this dish. So we are gonna go ahead and grab a bite. Oh my god, this is green in color. Spinach is all over it. Now let's go ahead. Nachos are really crispy. Wow, these are really delicious and very crispy. Can you hear that crunch? Wow, it's so crunchy. I really liked it. I really liked it how crunchy it is. Then those shredded chicken tikka pieces, then bell pepper and cheese, everything just all together and everything together really tasting fabulous. I'm kind of enjoying this dish. Now let's taste this thing with salsa. I'm already enjoying this thing so much and I feel that it could go really well with your drinks. If you're like just casually chilling with your friends, then this would really go while you're consuming any kind of alcohol. For that purpose, I think this dish is apt. So when you have these nachos with this salsa dip, it kind of changes the entire dish. The taste becomes sour. I think in both ways, the dish tastes absolutely stunning. Like if you have it with salsa, you don't have it with salsa, it's gonna taste fabulous, guys. I really liked it. I think if I ever come here again, which is going to happen very often, I'm definitely going to order this dish. So for this dish, thumbs up. Moving on, the next dish that we have over here is called Pollo a la Hongkaina. Look at this dish, guys. It's so beautiful. The presentation is perfect. These small little egg slices, I meant the boiled egg slices, and then chicken chunks dipped in yellow pepper, bell pepper sauce, and these vegetables. Oh my god, it's so creative. It's already looking so good. Now let's go ahead and try these yellow chicken chunks. Wow. This dish is on the spicier side. You can say that this sauce is spicy, cheesy bell pepper sauce, and I'm pretty much sure that it's made from yellow bell pepper. That's why this color is yellow. And I would say that this spiciness is kind of a hitting spiciness. These chicken pieces are kind of chewy, but I think it goes well with this dish. Let's have this yummy chicken chunks with some olives. I really want to taste like how this chicken would, you know, go well with olives. I kind of enjoy more with olives. I feel that the cheese sauce is going really well with olives, and anyways I feel that the sauce is something that I would prefer. It's cheesy, it's spicy, and then it's loaded with lots of chicken. So chicken and cheese is really having a great combination over here. And of course spicy food is my favorite, so yeah, I just loved it. With this delicious chicken, I really want to try these boiled eggs. Actually, this kind of combination never works for me because I'm not an egg person, but I really want to try these delicious chicken chunks with this boiled egg. So let's go ahead and grab a bite. It's actually tasting good, but I don't think so this kind of combination would really work for me because I generally don't prefer egg. But if you're kind of a person who loves eating egg, then this dish might work for you. This dish works for me, but not with eggs. I would prefer it without eggs than with eggs. So yeah, the dish is good. Chicken chunks are good. Sauce is amazing. So I guess I'm gonna enjoy my dish. For mains, we have called for gallo pinto. The name is quite interesting. So is the dish. Look at this dish, guys. It has this red bell pepper sauce, some beans, rice. Rice is also kind of red, and then some vegetables and chicken breast piece. Entirely, this dish looks quite filling. So let's go ahead and dig into this beautiful dish. This dish entirely looks quite filling because isme itna sara chicken and sauce hai. I feel that even two people can consume it. Cut the chicken. Even this dish is looking absolutely good, but what I have noticed regarding the dishes is it's like it's more like cheesy. Every dish has a lot of or great amount of cheese. So most of the dishes over here, or maybe the ones that I have called, are quite cheesy, but I feel that it works for me because it's spicy and sour. So that kind of a taste, I just enjoy it. Let me take a bite. The dish is quite saucy, guys. Matlab isme itna sara sauce bhara hai. It's tasting quite good. It's also really cheesy, and the red bell pepper thing, I would say that this dish is spicy and sweet. The combination is somewhere like, you know, sometimes when you have one bite, that spicy thing will hit you, and then on the other end if you have another bite, then the sweet thing will hit you. So it's kind of spicy and sweet. Also you can taste sour. I'm guessing that there's a lot of tomato in it, so all the three flavors you would taste. The chicken is cooked properly, it's tasting good. It has that you know, when you have the bite, the chicken feels juicy and full. The chicken is quite fresh, the vegetables are fresh, the rice is good, the sauce is amazing. So all together this dish is quite unique, and all these tastes like spicy, sweet and sour is kind of unique combinations. I think this dish deserves a thumbs up. I already had these three insane beautiful dishes. I'm not even over it, and they have landed me with this amazing surprise, which is called flower pot surprise. Look at this dish, guys. Look at this dessert. Isn't it looking amazing? You can actually get that vibe of, you know, flower pot with some beautiful rose on the top. I'm actually feeling like I'm gonna eat some mud over here. It kind of looks like that, right? But that's not the case. We are gonna dig in and find out that amazing surprise which is waiting for us. So let's go ahead. Oh, there is, I think this is Oreo or some chocolate thingy. Inside I can see vanilla ice cream and also some kind of chunks, which I need to have it and then see it. This dessert is actually full of surprises. The core ingredient of this dessert is Oreo chocolate biscuit. Also, it contains Oreo white cream, then vanilla ice cream, chocolate chunks, chocolate chips. All of these things are loaded in this particular dessert. Every time or every bite, you will taste something different. Sometimes you will taste chocolate chips, sometimes you will taste white cream, sometimes you will taste vanilla ice cream. Actually, vanilla ice cream you will taste altogether, because vanilla ice cream is, I think, one of the core ingredient other than Oreo chocolate biscuit. I guess this dessert is actually full of surprises, and I really like this kind of a rose that they have added to give a different dimension, or you can say that different look to this dessert. I will say that I'm kind of surprised. So guys, now we have come to the end of this vlog, and now we are gonna rate this place on our festive meter. So if I have to talk about this place is quite beautiful. It's a two-storied building, first floor and the ground floor. I would say that their first floor is more vibrant, lively. I feel that you would enjoy the first floor more than the ground floor. If I have to talk about their food is fabulous. They have a really vibrant and curated menu. You can say that they have Mexican, Italian, Japanese. So they have really diversified menu, which I loved about this place. Pricing wise also, this place is quite good. One dish would cost you around 350 to 450. Also, the quantity wise, the dishes are quite filling. One dish would surely fill you up, or you can just come here, order nachos and enjoy that nachos with your beer. So guys, the place is fabulous, and I'm gonna rate this place 9.7 out of 10 on my festive meter. This place is phenomenal and the food is incredible. I think I'm done over here. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, and also leave a comment in the comment section below telling me how was your experience, or any suggestion that you have, or any particular place that you want to see on my channel. I'm gonna end my vlog over here. See you in my next vlog. Till then, live life festive style. Bye-bye.